Now, before we get into the actual lesson, could you just do me one massive favor? Hit the like button on this video. Maybe even consider dropping a comment afterwards if you liked it as well. But hitting that like button really does throw the videos into the algorithm, and it'll help me get discovered by more people, get more views, buy more beers, have more fun. I owe you one. So I actually found that part so difficult. You can ask Gab. She kept coming into the lounge, and I just had my acoustic, like 2%. She was like, "That's getting better. We'll have it done for weekend." I was like, "Yeah, better I'd do." But basically, you're combining like an acoustic guitar part with a mandolin lead line, and you've got the right hand thumb alternating between both D strings, and you've got this melody on top of it. And because you keep going back to the first string with the third finger, and you're alternating with your index and your middle, you end up with like a series of pinches, and these three fingers change each time while the thumb seems to be doing something repetitive. It is, but it kind of like will send you around the houses, drive you nuts. But when you get it, it's like, oh my God, the coordination, payoff, let's go. Let's just talk about the tuning because it's very important. It's in double drop D. So your low E string goes down to a D and your high E string goes down to a D. Everything in the middle, all the same, but these two, both D. Throughout this, I'm going to refer to all the string names as normal, but this will be low D, middle D, and high D. So for the picking hand, the thumb is going to take care of anything on the bottom three strings. And index, middle, and right hand ring finger take care of the top three strings, and they get a string each. The thumb for this intro part will just alternate between both Ds. And then on top of that, we have to put this melody. When you think of it like that, it feels like chaos. But if we break it down into a series of pinches and walk through it step by step, it should all come together and end up cohesive and musical. And if it doesn't, you'll have me to deal with. Look at the size of me. Right, so I've got it here because when I play it slow, it goes to pop. We're not having that. Let's place our index finger across the seventh fret of the G, the B, and the high D. And to begin with, we hit the thumb, low D by itself. Index finger on the G by itself. And then we have our first pinch, and that will be middle D and the B string, second finger. Then high D by itself. Then we put our middle finger on the eighth fret of the B, and we pinch that with low D. Back to the high D. And then we take that middle finger off, we pinch it with the middle D and go back to the high D. All together, you've got this. Now we're going to put the third finger on the ninth fret of the G. We're going to pinch that with the low D and then hit the high D. Then that finger simply comes off. We do the same thing again, but our thumb has come over to the middle D now. This is where it started to get confusing for me because the thumb is repetitive, but the fingers keep changing their order. So now the third finger goes back to that nine, and you do the same thing again. Pinch low, hit high. And now we bring our thumb to the middle D, but this time we pinch the middle finger on the seventh fret of the B for our last note. Now, if you want to, you can hit the high D again, but I left it out because it makes the change to the first verse quite difficult. But if you put that note in, because it's a quaver away from the first chord of the verse, it's a bit more of a job to get into that first shape with the roll. So I just leave it on the seven with the middle D like that, and it gives me a breath to change to that first sort of roll in the first verse. Now, the other thing that I did, which was really difficult and annoying, because if you miss it, you've got to start again. And Gab has only got so much patience. But I tried to capture the descending harmonies that you can hear on the record whilst keeping the bass note. The harmonies at the top are thirds, but obviously because the D is dropped, they're not your usual third shapes. So the first one is going to be the eighth fret of the B and the ninth fret of the high D with the pinky. The other one will be same two fingers, but now both on fret seven, and then both on fret five. Now, when you stretch to that first one on the eighth and the ninth fret, you're going to need to put the index finger on the fifth fret of the low D and arch it over in such a way that you don't catch any of the other strings, because you need them open and that thumb needs to go back and forth with the middle D, like so. So that shape is not nice. And if you miss it, like I said, you miss it. You've got to carry on. Muscle on. So we start by pinching the thumb on the low D with the top two strings. Then we hit the G and the middle D. And then we move those two fingers down and we hit them again by themselves. Now we hit the thumb on the low D, and then we hit the G and the middle D. So it'll go thumb, index, thumb. Now at this point, when you snap these two back to the fifth fret, and you hit them with these two fingers, swap the bass note to the middle finger, because it'll let you grab the next two notes with ease. So this next bar goes like this. So we need to stretch our index finger back to the third fret of the B, have our third finger ready to hit the fifth fret of the B. It should already be there anyway, because it was from the previous harmony that we played. So making sure that that third finger is lifted up, you're going to go low D, G, middle D, B, with the respective fingers. Then we put the third finger down on the fifth fret, and you're going to go low D, B, middle D, G. All together, you get this. And when you speed them up and connect them together, it starts to make sense to the ear. And then that next little bit is dead simple. We're going to slide the index finger into the seventh fret of the G. And this is all the note D now. You're going to go. So the picking pattern goes low D, G, middle D, high D. Then it goes low D, G, middle D. And then to end that, I did this little riff. So we start with a low D pinch and the third finger on the ninth fret of the G, and you're going to slide that up to the 11. When you get there, you're going to hit the middle D and the high D. And then we're going to descend back to the 7 via the 9, but we hit the low D, then the 9 on the G, middle D, and then the 7 on the G. Back and forth whilst descending. And then the next bar is exactly the same as what we did previously, but we stick an extra 7 on the G at the end. It feels different because the bar before it is slightly busier. But it is just the same with that extra 7 on the end. So that verse variation goes like this. Sometimes I hit that 9 on the way back with the third finger, sometimes I hit it with the first. Depends what mood I'm in. Today, I'm in a good mood. And remember that really difficult mandolin bit that we just did. If you stick this part before it, and then go into it, you get the intro to the song. 2-for-1. And then obviously the really complicated big stretch. It just gives you something to practice, a taster. And then if you want the whole thing, like I said, head to my Patreon and check out the tab. It's got all the information you could need. I'm staring at it right now. It's got some little notes from me, some crap jokes. Tells you every finger to use on both hands. And you get to chat to me one-on-one, which in this day and age, considering how busy I am, is an absolute luxury. For as little as £5 a month. What does that get you nowadays? Chat with me. Perfect. Right, I'm starving, so I'm going to go because I need to eat leftover curry from yesterday. It was Gab's birthday. We got a curry. It was very nice. Thank you to everyone who sent her a little message. It was very sweet. Oh, did you hear that? I am. I'm starving. I've got to go. Right. But enough. If you need anything, give me a shout. But in the meantime, it's been emotional. Oh, yeah. Don't forget to hit like. Don't forget to hit like. Don't forget to hit the thumbs up like thing. That thing down there looks like that. Hit that, because if you do, like I said, I go viral and I turn into the new Mr. Beast. But genuinely, I would appreciate the support. It takes a lot of time to make these videos, even though you just think, oh, he's just knocking it out. And then he just puts it on his computer and uploads it. No, it takes time to edit. This color grade, I don't look this good in real life. I look like a little scragamuffin. This takes hours of editing across numerous different apps that cost a lot of money per month. It's all about money, isn't it? Unfortunately. All right, I'm sick of the sound of my own voice now. I'm going. Next week's going to be good, actually. I'm going to be putting some new pickups in my Les Paul. Why am I still talking? Right, see you later.